So?
We found him, Glenn.
Paul's alive.
For now. Solomon gave us some information about a man who wandered into his bar. He went by Kane Frazier. He's part of some gang that's camped out in Shady Creek.
He was bragging about some old-time outlaw that they caught around these parts, snooping around looking for bounties. And he also had this.
That's Paul's ring. I think he just gave this to you?
Well, no.
We talked to Solomon and he told us where he was staying and we talked.
I see.
Jericho and I are riding down to Shady Creek in the morning. It's a 2-day ride south. Look, I know you have a family to take care of now, so I understand if you don't want to go.
We just thought you wanted to know.
I'll talk to Sarepta.
I'll let you know in the morning.
What you doing? Sarepta.
There's nothing to talk about, Glenn. I know you're going with them. There's no point in asking me anything. Two days there and 2 days back, right?
Yeah. Look, the only reason I'm even considering doing this is because it's Paul. Alright? And when I come back, I'm done for good. I promise.
I know. That's why I'll still be here when you get back.
So Zarepta was really fine with you leaving.
In a way. I suppose if it was anything else, she'd be packing her own bags instead of mine.
You know, we could have really used her.
She don't do this anymore. She's got to be home with Danny. You need somebody.
I wish I had a wife that I could go home to.
So, tell me this. Any of the women you've been with know how to shoot a gun?
Well, no, she wouldn't need to do that.
You know, we'd have to tell her why we call you Jericho, Fred.
Come on, shut it.
You know, that's right, Clyde. We'd have to tell her all about the barn and that night he was drunk as a skunk.
Don't say it.
Tell me, Glenn, what happened to that barn?
Well, I'll tell you, Clyde.
Jericho got himself so piss-black drunk that he knocked the walls off that barn clear down.
Just like it says in the good book.
Big man Jericho.
Oh, there
he is.
Such a bad loser,
man. Big man Jericho over here.
All right, all right.
What do you think we'll find tomorrow?
Well, it's hard to say. We don't know how many of them there are. We don't even know anything about these people.
Do you think Paul's still alive?
I really don't know. We're either going to be saving him or we're going to be avenging him. Regardless of what he deserves.
What are you doing out here?
Why did you let Pa go?
It wasn't up to me.
You could have stopped him.
I know. I miss him too. But it's something he had to do.
I know.
Do you remember what I used to tell you when you were younger and you were sad?
Yeah.
How much does your daddy love you?
That much.
That's right. And how much do I love you?
That much.
That much. Go to bed. It's getting late.
God is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me.
Shame, isn't it, my boy?
Who are you?
I was a friend of your pa's. It came as soon as we heard the news. What's your name, son?
Danny.
Well, Danny, I made your dad a promise. Well, I think it's something you can help me with. What do you say?
Okay.
Great. I'm gonna need you to do something for me, okay? I gotta give you something, all right, Danny? But close your eyes, okay?
Okay.
Don't open them, all right? One. Two.
Drop it!
Can't do that, Sheriff.
Drop it or I'll shoot.
Now, how about you listen here, all right? You drop your weapon,
I can do my business and we can all go about our day. How's that sound?
Now, why would I do that?
Because the men behind you aren't as friendly as I am. Thank you, Sheriff. Now, Danny, I'm sorry I'm gonna have to do this, but you're gonna go see your daddy now. Gun. So when my boss finds out, he's gonna come after you and your boy.
Give me his name.
Deacon Jim. He's the one you can't run from.
Guess I'll have to find him first.